Hello, my name is Tamanna Chaudhary. I am an ex-Hansraj DU student, an AIIMS and NEET aspirant, and in 2017, that is this year, I was Air 1068 AIIMS. So enough with the show off, let us begin with the discussion. So this entire video is based on the topics like properties of dihydrogen and its commercial preparation, and once we have dealt with it, we'll move on to water. Let us begin. Now, first method to commercially prepare dihydrogen is electrolysis of water. Now, it is no news to us that when we electrolyze water, we get two products, hydrogen gas and oxygen gas at cathode and anode respectively. So this can be a very good way to, you know, prepare hydrogen. Next way is when we pass steam through coal at a very high temperature like 1270 Kelvin in presence of nickel catalyst, and what we get as product, that is carbon monoxide and hydrogen gas, is known as water gas or synthetic gas. Now the carbon monoxide is working as the villain here and H2 is our dulhania. Now the carbon monoxide won't let H2 to escape because carbon monoxide won't let hydrogen gas to escape because carbon monoxide would be self-dumbly very hard to remove. So what we do here is we pass more steam and in the presence of iron chromate at high temperature, and fir villain babu ki aa jati hai akal tikane, it becomes CO2 and we can easily remove it by scrubbing it with sodium arsenide. Now two name reactions, very important name reaction. This is the coal gasification reaction, that is the horizontal reaction, and this is the water gas shift reaction, the vertical reactions. Now a star point here is that pehle kya hota tha, jab CO and H2 sirf 1:1 molar ratio mein paaye jaate the tabhi hum usko water gas or synthetic gas bolte the, lekin ab aise koi restriction nahi hai. CO and H2 ka mixture at any proportion we call it as water gas or synthetic gas. So another process is Lane's process. What we do here, we pass steam through iron fillings. Wo oxidize ho jata hai apne oxide mein and hydrogen gas de deta hai. Now what we do with this iron oxide is that we pass water gas through it, giving carbon monoxide, H2O, and our iron is recovered. Another process is from methanol. What we do is we take methanol and water in 1:1 molar ratio in the presence of a special catalyst known as base metal chromide catalyst, and this reaction gives us water and synthetic gas. Wahi ghisi piti purani baate, hum steam pass karenge at very high temperature so that carbon monoxide changes into carbon dioxide and our hydrogen dulhania can be freed from the villain. Another process is when we pass steam through the hydrocarbon at high temperature, we get water gas, and फिर से वही करते हैं iron chromate की presence में at high temperature we pass steam and we get carbon dioxide and hydrogen gas. Now this process is known as steam reforming process. Now some properties of dihydrogen are: it is a colorless, tasteless and odorless gas. It is slightly soluble in water and it is highly combustible, which means that it supports combustion to a very high extent. It is the lightest substance known. Okay, we don't need someone to, you know, knock in our heads that it is the lightest substance known. Ek mass number hai, ek atomic number hai. What do you expect? Neutron hai nahi bichare ke paas. Now here are some chemical reactions of hydrogen. This is the disintegration reaction. जब हम 2000 केल्विन पे ही इसको हीट करते हैं तो सिर्फ 0.081% डिसोसिएट होता है, बट एट मोर हायर टेम्परेचर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल एट 5000 केल्विन 95.5% डिसोसिएशन अकर्स. नाउ विद मेटल्स, it form ionic hydrides when the metal is an active metal and interstitial hydride when the metal is an interstitial metal. Now these interstitial hydrides shows the property of occlusion, that is occlusion is the absorption of, simple as that. अब हमें मुझे वाटर की फॉर्मेशन बतानी ज़रूरी तो लग नहीं रही है, बट आई नीड टू से दैट दिस रिएक्शन इज़ वेरी एक्सोथर्मिक, बहुत बहुत अमाउंट में हीट प्रोड्यूस होती है. एंड व्हेन हाइड्रोजन गैस रिएक्ट्स विद नाइट्रोजन गैस वी गेट अमोनिया, एंड दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज हेबर्स प्रोसेस. वील बी डीलिंग इट इन ग्रेट डिटेल वंस वी स्टार्ट विद यू नो आर पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स. विद हेलोजन्स इट फॉर्म हेलोजन एसिड. With carbon at this temperature it forms methane, but at slightly more higher temperature we get C2H2. Now hydrogen reacts with metal oxides to give metal and water, but the metal oxides I am talking about here should not be of active metals. For example, it should not be sodium, it should not be any S block element or any reactive metal. Now with carbon monoxide it forms methanol. अब ये जो process है ये bulk preparation of methanol में use होती है, so it is kind of important. Now hydrogen it also helps in hydrogenation of oil. अब ये जो मैंने आपको बताया था कि ये जो हेलोजन एसिड प्रोड्यूस होता है, रिएक्टिविटी ये है, फ्लोरीन सबसे ज़्यादा रिएक्टिव है इस रिएक्शन में, देन फॉलोड बाय क्लोरीन, देन ब्रोमीन एंड देन आयोडीन. Now these are the nuclear spin isomers of hydrogen, that is they differ from both of them only with respect to the nuclear spin. Ortho mein spin same direction mein spin ho rahi hai and para mein different direction mein, opposite direction mein spin ho rahi hai. So let us see that when we vary temperature how does their ratio change. At 0 Kelvin, that is very low temperature, mainly para hydrogen is formed. And when we slightly increase the temperature, for example at the temperature at which air liquefies, ortho and para are found in the ratio 1:1. And at more higher temperature, for example at room temperature 300 Kelvin, ortho and para are in 3:1 ratio, that is we get 75% ortho. Ab isse zyada ortho hume kami kabhi bhi nahi milega, but yes we can get pure para at low temperature, for example 20 Kelvin. Now these nuclear isomers की physical properties ज़्यादा affect नहीं होती है इनके nuclear spin के direction से. Also thermal conductivity of para is 50% greater than that of ortho, and melting point of para is 0.15 Kelvin lesser than the melting point of 75% pure ortho. Now important uses of dihydrogen is that it is used in bulk preparation of organic compounds like methanol. It is used as in rocket fuel and also in fuel cells because it gives high power and it causes no pollution. It is used in atomic torches or oxyhydrogen torches. हम क्या करते हैं, हम हाइड्रोजन पास करते हैं टंगस्टन रॉड के थ्रू, जो कि बहुत बहुत हाई टेम्परेचर पे होता है, एंड वी दिस रिजल्ट्स इन डिसोसिएशन ऑफ हाइड्रोजन गैस इनटू एटॉमिक हाइड्रोजन विच इज़ वेरी रिएक्टिव, एंड दिस रिएक्शन इज सो एक्सोथर्मिक एंड दैट इट द हीट प्रोड्यूस इज सफिशियंट टू कट द मेटल, इट्स दैट एक्सोथर्मिक. Starting with the water, it is the universal solvent, that is it has a high dielectric constant and hydrogen bonding is also shown by it, so it can dissolve almost everything, so we say it is the universal solvent. It makes 65% of our body and 68% of the earth's surface. This is the structure of hydrogen, दो bond pair, दो lone pair. इन दो lone pair की वजह से हमारा angle 104.5 degree है, जो कि expected angle 109.5 degree से कम है. This is the tetrahedral angle and the water is showing the angle lesser than it, so the structure is distorted or bent. Now as these bonds are polar, we'll have a dipole moment, so yes, water does have a dipole moment of 1.84 dive. When hydrogen bonding occurs, oxygen is surrounded by four hydrogen, two covalent bonded honge और दो हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डेड होंगे. ऐसे जब आइस बनती है तो आइस का जो स्ट्रक्चर होता है वो ओपन स्ट्रक्चर होता है, एंड आइस हैज़ डेंसिटी लोअर देन दैट ऑफ वाटर. Now, iron has maximum density of 4 degrees at 4 degrees Celsius, and this property is very important to sustain aquatic life because in winters the upper water layer will form ice, but this ice formation will help this water to be at a comparatively higher temperature, thus sustaining life. अब हमें इसका फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट पता है, हमें बॉइलिंग पॉइंट पता है, हमें पता है मैक्सिमम डेंसिटी 1 ग्राम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब होती है 4 डिग्री सेल्सियस पे. अब इसकी कुछ प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक जो फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट हो गया, बॉइलिंग पॉइंट हो गया, एंथैल्पी ऑफ फ्यूजन एंड वेपराइजेशन होगी, दे आर स्लाइटली हायर देन द हाइड्राइड्स ऑफ ग्रुप 16 एलिमेंट विच इज़ द ग्रुप फ्रॉम विच द ऑक्सीजन बिलोंग्स, बिकॉज ये हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग शो करता है. नाउ ये वाटर हैज़ द कैपेसिटी टू डिजॉल्व मोस्ट ऑफ द इनऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंस, बट हायर प्रेशर पे इट बिहेव एज अ नॉन पोलर सॉल्वेंट, दैट इज इट विल डिजॉल्व ऑर्गेनिक बट विल नॉट डिजॉल्व inorganic substances. Now 9 crystalline forms of ice are known. Two important of them are here, that is at atmospheric pressure normal hexagonal form is shown, but at very low temperature ice takes the cubical form, not cubical form in as we find in our trace, but cubical structure mein inke bond formation hoti hai. Chemical properties is that it is highly stable because of highly negative enthalpy of formation. अगर जब हम इसको 1500 केल्विन पे हीट करते हैं 2% डिसोसिएट होता है ये, एंड जब हम करंट पास करते हैं दैट इज इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस करते हैं तो H2NO2 फॉर्म होते हैं. नाउ इट इज एम्फोटेरिक इन नेचर, दैट इज इट कैन एक्ट एज एन एसिड एज वेल एन बेस. इट विल एक्ट एज एन एसिड जब हम इसको इससे स्ट्रॉन्गर बेस से रिएक्ट कराते हैं, फॉर एग्जाम्पल अमोनिया, एंड इट विल एक्ट एज बेस वेन जब हम इसको इससे ज़्यादा स्ट्रॉन्गर एसिड के साथ रिएक्ट कराते हैं, फॉर एग्जाम्पल HCl. सो इसका pH होगा 7 एंड इट विल बी न्यूट्रल टू litmus. Now it will show the property of oxidizing character as well as reducing character. It will act as an oxidizing reagent जब हम इसको highly electropositive metal, for example sodium से react कराते हैं, water will change into H2, thus getting reduced. It will work as an reducing agent जब हम इसको highly electronegative metal, for example halogens के साथ react कराते हैं, यहाँ पर water will change into O2 into HF. Thus, it will get what? It will get oxidized. This also occurs during photosynthesis. It will act as a reducing agent. अब hydration reactions ये तीन form में show करता है. Either the water can be linked to the metal ion complex in the coordinated form, for example in this complex ion, or it can be hydrogen bonded, for example in CuSO4 5H2O. Four of these H2O are coordinate bonded, but the fifth water molecule is hydrogen bonded to the SO4 ion. Now third way is जब water molecules are present in voids, for example in barium chloride 2H2O, these 2H2O molecules are present in voids of the structure of BaCl2. I am pretty fast. Now these are the hydrolysis reactions. Now water will hydrolyze oxides into hydroxides, halides into their acids, carbides into into hydroxides and giving byproducts. अब आपको सिर्फ byproducts याद रखने हैं इस केस में, बिकॉज हमें हाइड्रोक्साइड तो मिल ही रही है. इन केस ऑफ कार्बाइड विल गेट C2H2, इन केस ऑफ हाइड्राइड विल गेट H2, इन केस ऑफ नाइट्राइड विल गेट NH3, इन केस ऑफ फॉस्फाइड्स विल गेट फॉस्फीन. So here we complete with the properties of dihydrogen and that of water. In the next video we'll be discussing about the hydrides and its types with brief overview of each one of them. Thank you so much.